Hello everyone, I'm Deputy Chief Daryl Tollison with the Atlanta Police Department, and welcome to the fifth episode of my vlog. Today I need your help in solving a homicide, and we're starting right now. Hello everyone, today we've returned to the scene of the crime of our very first homicide of 2017. It occurred January the 2nd here at 96 Broad Street. And I have with us today our homicide commander, Lieutenant Ricardo Vasquez. Lieutenant, tell us what happened here.
So we responded to a person down call, and when we arrived at this location, we did locate Mr. Minnick, who was lying on the sidewalk in a lot of blood.
He was just laying here?
He was just laying there, just laying on the sidewalk. Initially, we thought he had been shot, but after a further investigation, we found that he had been struck with a blunt object that caused a lot of trauma and caused him to bleed quite a bit.
And we've got a homicide tactical canvas here. We're about to roll that out.
We're gonna come back out today and really scour the streets and just try to see if there's anybody that we missed during our initial investigation. We hope to really talk to anybody that was out here that hasn't had an opportunity to contact us. So we're hoping to touch anybody we didn't touch the day of the investigation.
Oh, very good. Okay.
I'm waking up to ash and dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus.
All right, first of all, I want to thank everybody who came out to support the canvas. If you don't know, what we're here is to do a tactical canvas for Investigator Egbert's open homicide. It was the first one we had this year that occurred over on Broad Street. So while you're out there talking to people and handing out flyers, you kind of have an idea of what it is that he needs for us to be able to close this case.
I appreciate you guys coming out. On January 2nd at about 6:30 in the morning, the body of Dimitri Manek was found at 96 Broad Street Southwest, which was, according to the medical examiner, he had blood force trauma to the back of his head. Looks like he was hit a couple times with something. So far, I have found no witnesses who said they saw the actual murder.
All right, so we just finished up the homicide briefing. Now we're on the way to do the tactical canvas. While they do that, I'm going to take you to Midtown to meet my robbery commander, Lieutenant A.Z. Horn. He's up on the scene where a very violent robbery has occurred, and we're in the process of looking for a suspect. So I want you to go with me to that.
Sunday afternoon, around 1:40, female victim parked her car in the parking lot and came over to the kiosk to pay for her parking. While she was focused on the machine, assuming that a perpetrator came from behind her to assault her. Just wanted to show you the location.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. And as you can see, it seems he came up the hill, saw the victim paying for a parking and putting the receipt in a window. While her back was turned, the subject came behind her and tried to pull her purse off his shoulder. The perpetrator withdrew a knife and slashed the throat of the victim, female victim from Lectina.
So
the Good Samaritan, the male witness, saw this, tried to assist the woman, but her neck was already cut. The perpetrator fled with her purse and ran over to this fence line over here, jumped over the fence, the Chevron on Piedmont and Ponce de Leon. We captured the perpetrator on video at that location. Our victim, once she became well again, she gave us a composite sketch of the perpetrator. Once we got that composite sketch photo for a booking photo, we got that photo and we confirmed and put that in the lineup to our victims and our witness.
And our witness.
And our witness confirmed that that was the same perpetrator that caused the assault.
So we have a warrant on this guy now?
We do.
We have a warrant on him for robbery.
Hey guys, you know, just a few minutes ago, we were at a robbery scene in Midtown Atlanta where a man snatched a woman's purse and then cut her throat. And if you recall, I showed you this suspect. Well, this suspect is now on this plane pulling up. Our fugitive unit went to South Carolina and brought him back, and then we're about to take him where he belongs.
Appreciate you guys coming out. We have a significant announcement today to make on a significant violent robbery we had in Midtown Atlanta, but I want to introduce two people. First is Lieutenant A.Z. Horn, who is our robbery commander, and of course, Major Scott Crayer, who is his own 5 commander.
Thank you for being here today for this closure of a violent robbery which occurred in the Midtown area on March 26. First of all, I would like to thank all of the law enforcement partners within the Atlanta area and the South Carolina area who assisted with this arrest.
Good afternoon, everyone. I just wanted to touch on a few things. Midtown is a very safe place to be. We work very hard with our partners in the community, both in the business community and in the residential communities of Midtown.
Okay, guys, I just wanted to give a quick acknowledgement to some of the good folks who have sent us some more patches and coins in support of our vlog, as well as our other social media platforms. First is Joan Heath. Joan Heath is the Director of Public Affairs for the Georgia Department of Corrections, and she sent me several of their patches in, so thank you very much for that. The next is Monica Garcia, who's not in law enforcement, but has many clients who are in law enforcement, and she had them bring her several patches, and she now has mailed them to us. So the Pentagon, Arlington, Virginia, Metropolitan Police, so thank you, Monica, for that. The next one is Jason Hedden, Commander Jason Hedden of the Los Banos, California Police Department. Thank you, Jason, for that patch. Ryan Hooper sent me one from his personal collection from Walterboro, South Carolina PD. And then Chief Keith Meadows, an old colleague of mine here in APD, sent me a patch from College Park Police Department, his agency that he now runs. And Lieutenant McCreary also joined him in sending me that. So thank you very much, Chief. Dee Marshall is an old friend of mine who sent me several of her patches from attending law enforcement conferences all over the country. So she sent me some, wanted me to put these in my collection. Thank you, Dee. And then Massachusetts College of Art and Design. These guys are very active in social media. So thank you, Sergeant Huey, for sending me a patch from your agency. And the last I have for this vlog is the City of Morrow Fire Department. It was sent to me by Renee Reagan and Elton Pauls. Thank you guys very much. Thank all of you for sending me these patches. I'm going to add them to my collection. And thank you for watching and supporting our vlog. Until next time, be well and stay safe.